This presentation is an introduction to Tourette syndrome intended for medical students. The objective of this presentation is for the learner to be able to understand what is Tourette syndrome, recognize the features of Tourette syndrome, understand which population is affected, and have a brief understanding of the management. What is Tourette syndrome? Tourette syndrome is a tic disorder involving involuntary vocal and motor movement with a neuropsychiatric etiology. It can be classified as simple or complex. It's often preceded by urge or sensation in the affected muscle group. Completing it is a certain way or a certain number of times that relieve the urge. Tics are often worse with excitement or anxiety. The first onset is usually between the age of 3 to 9 years of age. Male to female ratio is 3 or 4 to 1. The prevalence of Tourette syndrome is between 0.4 to 3%. The DSM define a tic as a sudden, rapid movement, non-rhythmic, stereotype motor movement or vocalization. The exact definition is as listed below. In Tourette syndrome, this tic vary significantly between patient and can also vary at different stages of a patient's life and in a different environmental stresses. The wide variety of presentation has led some researchers to suggest that Tourette syndrome may not be a unitary disorder. This slide shows example of simple and complex tic. The tic that's most widely recognized and associated with Tourette syndrome in popular culture is coprolalia. However, in reality, only about 10% of Tourette syndrome patients has coprolalia. The most common tics involve eye blinking and throat clearing. The diagnosis of Tourette syndrome can usually be made based on history and observation of the tics. No major investigations are needed most of the time to diagnose Tourette syndrome. One should always try to exclude reversible causes of movement disorder. If there are any unusual features, then further investigation should be made based on the features elicited. Up to 90% of patients have comorbid disorder, of which the most common are OCD and ADHD. In these patients, the tics may not be as disabling as the comorbid disorder. Genetic epidemiology studies suggest that Tourette syndrome has a definite inherited component. However, the exact pattern inheritance is still unknown and may involve autosomal dominant, bilinear, or polygenic mechanism. No genes are yet to be associated with Tourette syndrome. Management is entirely symptomatic and should be tailored to the symptoms of the patient from a biopsychosocial perspective. Quite often, it is the comorbid condition which are more disabling than the tics themselves. Behavioral therapy can often be used to reduce the tics. The behavioral therapy being studied for use in tic treatment is habit reversal therapy. One study showed that the majority of patients treated with habit reversal therapy are able to remain tic-free. Antipsychotics has been extensively studied and used in tic management with 50 to 80% improvement in symptoms. Both typical and atypical antipsychotics have been shown to improve symptoms. Atypical may be preferable for its side effects profile. Alpha-2 adrenergic agonists have also been tried with promising results in up to 40 to 70% of patients. However, this is not an FDA-approved usage. In summary, Tourette syndrome is a common tic disorder. Its exact pathophysiology is unknown, but there's a strong genetic component. It tends to be lifelong and chronic, usually having an onset early childhood with an early peak but wanes by adulthood. Management is largely symptomatic and should focus on symptoms or comorbid disorder that are most troubling to the patient. Thank you.